Pretty much every networking course and book written about networks talks about the purpose of a network, which is to share resources. But equally important, we need to be able to find those resources on the network. Important network services need to be able to resolve things like hosts. And that's where DNS comes in. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to configure a reverse lookup zone within DNS in Windows Server 2019. Now, don't forget, if you do enjoy the video, please give it a like and leave a comment below. And if you haven't subscribed to the IT Taster channel, hit the subscribe button. So with that said, let's get started. DNS zones contain records that map hosts to IP addresses. In this example, we can see stations 1 to 4 and their IP address mappings. There are two important zones I want to quickly talk about. The first one is the forward lookup zone. A forward lookup zone contains host records and their IP address mappings. This is where normal DNS queries take place. Normal DNS queries are known as forward lookup queries. This involves querying the DNS server with a host name and its fully qualified domain name. If a record for the host exists, the server will return, that is, resolve the host's IP address. Now, the other type of zone that I want to talk about is the reverse lookup zone, which does the opposite. The reverse lookup zone stores IP address to host mappings, and this is where reverse lookup queries take place. A reverse lookup query involves querying the DNS server with an IP address. This time, if a record for the IP address exists, the server will return a host name and its fully qualified domain name. Let's now go over to the lab and take a quick look at this in action using a client workstation. Okay, so I've logged into a Windows 10 client workstation. I'm going to open up a command prompt. I'm going to begin by performing a forward lookup query. The command that I'm going to use is nslookup. Then I need to type the host that I want to look up. I'm going to do a forward lookup of my server, which is called server1. I then need to enter the fully qualified domain name, which in my case is training.ittaster.com, and hit return. Now there are a couple of short timeouts there. But we can see server1.training.ittaster.com resolves to the IP address of 192.168.1.101. So let's now try performing a reverse lookup of server 1. To do that, we need to type nslookup again. This time we just need to type the IP address, because remember, a reverse lookup will resolve an IP address to a host name. Server's IP address is 192.168.1.101. Now, as you can see, the server is unable to resolve the reverse lookup. And this is because the server doesn't yet have a reverse lookup zone configured. That's what we're going to do next, so let's go over to the server. I've logged into my Windows 2019 server, and as you can see, I'm in Server Manager. From here, I need to click Tools, open DNS. I need to expand my DNS server, Server 1. Click Reverse Lookup Zones, and then right-click Reverse Lookup Zones, and choose New Zone. I need to click Next on the first screen of the New Zone wizard. I'm going to leave primary zone selected as the zone type and click next. And I'm also going to leave the default Active Directory zone replication scope as to replicate to all DNS servers running on domain controllers in this domain and click next. I want to create an IP version 4 reverse lookup zone and click next. I need to enter my network ID, and in my case it's 192.168.1. and click Next. Again, I'm going to stick with the defaults here to allow only secure dynamic updates, which is recommended for Active Directory, and click Next. And we get an overview of our configuration. There is one important thing to note. It says you should now add records to the zone or ensure that records are updated dynamically. And we'll do this in a moment. And I can click Finish. I'm going to expand my reverse lookup zone. And as we can see, we have two records in there, but we don't have a pointer record for my server. Now, there is an easy way to create this. I'm going to open up a command prompt. And the command I'm going to use is ipconfig / register DNS. Let's just close that down and refresh the screen. And as you can see, our pointer record has been created for us. So let's now go over to our Windows 10 workstation in the lab and perform a reverse lookup and see if it's successful. I've logged back onto my Windows 10 workstation and I'm now ready to try a reverse lookup. So we need to type NS lookup. And I'm going to try a reverse lookup of my server first. And my server's IP address is 192.168.1.101. Now notice this time it actually resolves the server's name for the DNS server as well, because we've got that reverse lookup pointer record. And as we can see, the IP address 192.168.1.101 resolves to server1.training.ittaster.com. Let's also try this for our workstation. Our workstation's IP address was 192.168.1.210. And as you can see, this also resolves to station2.training.ittaster.com. Now, if you remember, we had to add a pointer record for our server, and you may be wondering what happens with our clients. Well, the client workstation is configured to get an IP address from DHCP, and as it restarts, it will register within DNS, and a pointer record will be created dynamically. Well, as you've seen, it's pretty easy to create a reverse lookup zone in DNS. And I also think it's something that is really useful. For example, if you're sifting through log files and you see an IP address that you need to identify a host, for example, you can quickly perform a reverse lookup using the NS lookup command. So that brings us to the end of the video. I hope you found it useful and helpful. If you did, please give the video a like and drop a comment below as well. And if you haven't already, please remember to subscribe to the ittaster channel. So as always, thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.